A year ago, I talked about some terrible Mario bootleg games on Android. Who could forget such classics such as Super Smash Jungle World, Santa Classic Mario World, and the totally original Super Marlow Run? They're laughable, sure. But with mobile games, well, there's very little quality control, especially with the Google Play Store. To sum it up, anyone can make a mobile game, have it go through Google Play's rigorous quality control, and make money from it. Until they get taken down, of course. Console games are a different story. Developing games is harder, and there's way more regulations on what's actually published. But that didn't stop our good friends in China from slipping under the radar and making some bootleg Mario games for a variety of different consoles. Check this out. Here's one I have. Not only do we have Super Mario Bros. 2 and 3, but Super Mario Bros. 6, 9, 10, 14, and 16. What kind of rock was I living under? I thought there were only 3 Mario games. What on earth is this? We got Paper Mario and Luigi with the title screen Mine Kids? Well, guess what? Two of these games are official Mario games, which are Mario 2 and 3, while the others are just hacks of games with the main character being swapped out with Mario. I mean, look at this, they just replaced Buster Bunny with Mario. At least this one kinda feels like Mario. Prototype of Super Mario Odyssey? Nah, it's Joe and Mac. That's all fine and dandy, but a majority of these bootleg games are just hacks of already existing games. As funny as Seven Granddad is, all it is a hack of Flintstones Rescue Dino and Hoppy, which is a mediocre, but not horrible game. But the good news, or maybe bad news, is there exists quite a few games made from the ground up, starring the main man himself, Mario. These bootleg games were mainly made for the Famicom, and there's a reason for that. Because the NES came out right after the video game crash, quality control was crucial, and that's why Nintendo added a lockout chip to prevent unlicensed games from playing on it. You know, like games made by dog food companies. That's also why you'll barely see any bootleg games for the NES. Sure, there's some unlicensed games like Tengen Games, but Tengen was a subsidiary of Atari and an actual company rather than some underground game developer from God knows where. But the Famicom is a different story. It had no lockout chip, making it very easy to recreate the hardware, and a lot of developing countries that didn't have access to the Famicom or NES in the 90s got these systems, such as China, most of South America, and most notably Russia with their bootleg Famicom Dendy, actually causing Nintendo to give the company that made it the rights to distribute the Super Nintendo in Russia. But the strangest part of all is they still exist and are being sold around the world. I was at a mall a few years back, and there was this kiosk selling this monstrosity for $30, and I was gonna buy one too, but I got a GameCube instead. Good choice. You know how I said a lot of these systems were aimed towards developing countries? That also meant they didn't get a lot of modern game consoles, and the game I'm about to show you is one of the many examples of bootleg Famicom ports of games from newer systems. This is Super Mario World for the Famicom. Let's take a look at the cartridge. You have Super Mario World on the cover, various Mario characters, but need to cover up Mario's head with Peaches? As if that's gonna help if you get sued. Legal issues aside, how is the actual game? The game is made from scratch, and you can clearly tell this isn't something made by Nintendo. Mario runs really fast, but has this awkward jump where he slows down in the middle of a jump. It feels really weird, but you'll get the hang of it. All the levels are just ripped from Super Mario World and are out of order. Not all the levels are present, but that's to be expected. Graphic-wise, the game looks pretty good, and despite a few inconsistencies, it's pretty faithful to the original. Music is a different story. Some tracks sound okay, but others sound terrible, and they don't match the levels either. But the thing I find the most interesting about this game is that Yoshi is playable. Miyamoto said that including Yoshi wasn't possible on the NES, but this game proved him wrong on that. Overall, Super Mario World from the Famicom is sluggish, inconsistent, and not very good. However, if all you have is a Famicom or a Famiclone, it certainly beats not playing Super Mario World at all. It does alright emulating the original, even though it's sloppy. Even just for the novelty of playing Super Mario World on the Famicom, I'd recommend it. But just do the right thing and play the SNES or GBA versions that weren't made in someone's basement. Just do the right thing. I want to play Super Smash Bros., but my Switch dock is fried, there's an English muffin in my GameCube, my Wii is being used for a Zumba class, and I'm allergic to the Wii U. All I have is this bootleg Famicom, a Game Boy, and a tinfoil ball with toothpicks sticking out of it. Wait, I got it. Kart Fighter is a game made for the Famicom, released in 1994, a whole 5 years before Super Smash Bros. It's pretty much a Street Fighter clone, with a selection of Mario characters. All the characters from Super Mario Kart are playable, and while the sprites are kinda weird looking, at least they resemble who they're supposed to be. Usually I would be making jokes like, haha, Mario looks silly, and this and that, but to be truthful, it's hard making jokes about the game, because it's honestly pretty fun. Despite being a bootleg game, it controls well, it looks and sounds alright, and most importantly, it's fun to play. It's a lot better than most licensed fighting games for the Famicom and NES, and sometimes I wonder if this was the inspiration for Smash Bros. Definitely recommend it. There are still quite a few Famicom games I'm gonna cover, but before I'm gonna get to the good stuff, let's take a look at a bootleg Mario game for the Game Boy. Although not as bad as the Famicom's problem with bootlegs, the Game Boy isn't exactly a saint when it came to avoiding them. But man, when you find one, you'll know damn well this is not endorsed by Nintendo. This is Super Mario Land DX for the Game Boy Color. Look at the cartridge! What the heck is wrong with Mario? Is this from the cancelled Mario movie directed by Michael Bay? Or is it Mario after he smoked crack? And the background looks like it was ripped from one of those Play Mario games online from the 2000s websites that gave you viruses even Dr. Mario couldn't cure. So what's this monstrosity like? It's just Super Mario Land with color, and made to be a little bit harder. I'm honestly disappointed that we don't see Mario having some hard times like he is on the box art, but yeah, it's just a modified version of Super Mario Land, meaning it's gonna be a good game, but I'm sure most of you have played it already. Now on to the good stuff. Shrek was a major icon of 2000s pop culture. He had two awesome movies, and even though Shrek the Third and Shrek Forever After were mediocre in my opinion, that didn't stop his popularity. So during the peak of his popularity, what on earth do you think the bootleggers decided to do? Make a Famicom bootleg based on Shrek. By the 2000s, the Famicom was well on its way out, but like I said earlier, bootleg games for the system are still being made today. You will be amazed when I boot this up. You ready for it? Super Shrek Brothers. I said I wouldn't really focus on hacks earlier, but this is a game so bizarre I had to cover it. You take control of what I think is Mike Wazowski at first, and then transform into Shrek. If it were just Mario swapped out for Shrek, I'd probably laugh and ignore the game. But whoever decided to make this changed all the graphics. Everything is changed to fit the Shrek theme, albeit very loosely, and for that person who said, "Man, I wish there was a Shrek version of Super Mario Brothers," you're in luck. It's the PAL version of Super Mario Brothers, so it'll play faster, but otherwise it's the same game. I'm just really baffled something like this even exists. But if you thought this was bizarre, it's gonna get way weirder in the next game. Remember how I said a lot of developing countries didn't get newer consoles? That also included the Genesis at the time. And at the time, Sonic was on top of the world with Mario. So what did these bootleggers decide to do? Make a port of Sonic for the Famicom, starring Mario. Thus, so Mario was born. This game just leaves me at a loss for words. Someone had the audacity to say, "Hey, a port of Sonic isn't good enough, let's replace Sonic with the fat Italian plumber. That'll be a great idea." Yeah, the actual game is as great as the idea was. Terrible. The controls are clunky, the game runs at a sluggish pace, the hit detection is virtually non-existent, and it's overall pure garbage. The levels are ripped from Sonic 1, and I'll say that game didn't have the best level design to begin with, and here it's the same thing, but on weaker hardware, so it's gonna be worse. The game is terrible, and there also exists a version that has Sonic as a main character, but because of how absurd it is, why not give it a go? It's way worse than Super Mario World, to the point where it's almost unplayable, but hey, it sure is weird. But what could possibly be worse than this? Dion Shimali, also known as Lima Shi Dion, also known as TV Mari, is the worst thing I have ever put into any game system. Heck, I'm sure I could have more fun playing a video game with a potato. Apparently, Mario from the cover of Super Mario Land DX has had even harder times, because in this game, it looks like he's gone from crack to meth and devoted the rest of his life to gamble on fruit. All you do in this game is push a button and bet on fruit. That's it. There's no strategy, there's no purpose. It's just luck. The goal of the game is to win, but with the game, there also has to be strategy involved and an overall purpose to play the game. What more can be said? This is one of the few games where I can't say anything positive about it. Gameplay is non-existent, the game looks awful, it's easily the worst game I've ever played. I have it on this 501 multi-cart, but the fact that cartridges with only this game exist make me sad. Imagine if you were that poor kid in the 90s who could only get one game and chose this because Mario was on the cover and went home and played it and it was this monstrosity. And apparently it's made by Namco? Get the out of here. Well, that about covers it for the Mario bootlegs on the Famicom I wanted to talk about. From sloppy Mario World to Mario's awful years, there sure were some doozies. Anyone can make a low-effort hack, but it's interesting to see that there were developers out there that made bootleg Mario games from the ground up. Most of them are pretty bad, but it's fun to see what these people came up with, and in the end, you're better off just playing the official Mario games. Anyways, thanks for watching, and keep calm and grandad on.